That was Push, Madison versus Madison, and we're here with the filmmakers Rudy Hypolite and Coach Dennis Wilson. Thanks for being with us.
Thanks for having us.
What exactly did you all want people to see through this film?
For me, I wanted to show the kids and give a little insight into their lives, how challenging their lives were at home, and now trying to use basketball and academics as a way to change their circumstance.
There was a powerful story to tell, a compelling story to tell, a story that, you know, I felt that would be able to touch people, inspire people, and get the real message and story out.
And you grew up in the neighborhood or in the projects that are featured in the film, is that
yes.
correct?
Raheem Singleton in the film comes from Academy Home. That's where I grew up.
So you have a real personal connection to
Yeah, and that's why this story resonated. It's stories that I saw, friends that I grew up with who are now incarcerated or, you know, had gone a different path. So I wanted to tell this story because I wanted to tell people that we have to do this differently. We can't do what we're doing now in the public school system. We can't do what we're doing now in the neighborhood.
I know that you played basketball before, but I didn't get a really strong sense of what your own personal history was.
Born and raised in Roxbury, Massachusetts, which is a neighborhood right 5 minutes, 10 minutes from Boston. Single parent home, although my dad was in my life, but my dad wasn't a very good husband and father. My mom, who was very influential and very instrumental in my life in terms of a hard-working woman that just constantly, you know, emphasize education and hard work and so on, and being caring about people and doing good by people. She passed away when I was 18. She asked me before she passed away, would I promise her to be the first to graduate from college? I end up getting my BS degree in secondary education, and I end up becoming a teacher.
Now, you had a good role model when you were growing up, and you graduated. You fulfilled your promise to her. What about the high dropout rate in the high schools? And what are you doing to try to address it?
You know, it's very sad. The school systems have to be revamped. They have to make the educational system more attractive to kids. When I was going to school, you know, we had art and we had music appreciation and all those fun things that you could do. The curriculum has to change, you know. It has to be things, again, that is gonna make young men and young ladies analytical and critical thinkers, you know, rather than teaching to a test. You know, there are a lot of very capable, smart young ladies and young men that may not test well. That doesn't mean they can't be successful.
And what have you been able to do, or what do you try to do to keep kids in school?
Make it engaging, make it fun. Let them experience succeeding. Mm-hmm. You know, like when I taught the kids that, you know, were challenged, I would give them questions that I know they could answer. When a kid that was challenged intellectually and academically would answer a question, and the other kids would, yeah, way to go, Tyrone, way to go, you know, Jasmine, you know. So that was like, oh, so they enjoyed coming to my class. I had some real tough characters, and the teacher would say, well, how did you get, you know, Larry or Tyrone to come to class? I said, one, I let them know I care about them. Two, they learn. Three, I make it easy and adapt my lessons to them so they can learn and really enjoy being there.
And what was your school experience versus what you saw at Madison Park?
It was two different eras, and I'm kind of dating myself, but basically, you know, my experience when I was in school, we were dealing with school busing and desegregation. You know, black kids going into different neighborhoods for school, being taunted and threatened by the white community. I think high school is very different now. I think kids today are dealing with so many more challenges at home, you know, as we
like
mentioned.
What?
You know,
what are they so, the issues?
Well, they're dealing with, you know, gang activity, so it's a matter of survival. It's whether, you know, your mom or your dad might be, you know, incarcerated. Who's the breadwinner? Am I going to get something to eat? How can you concentrate on academics if you're at home and you're wondering whether you're going to make it for that day, whether you're going to get something to eat for that day?
I noticed that drugs weren't mentioned in the film. I know a lot of kids in school were smoking marijuana and doing other things. Why did you guys leave that out?
It's not something in the time that we were filming that we captured, but I don't know.
So you haven't had any issue with any of your players?
Oh, yes, to be honest, yes. There may be drug addicts in the family. drug addicts next door, drug dealers next door, drug dealers on the corner, going past drug dealers, and so they see it. The ones with the fast money, the glitz and the glitter, you see? So they're like, oh, wow, man, he's high roller. Look at what he's wearing. Look at the jewelry. Look at the sneakers. You know, look at the car. Look at the clothes, you see? So you have to let them know that it's a no-win situation. You all got to take care of your body, your temple. You want to go to Division I school, go pro, how could you destroy your body if you put that stuff in it?
Do sports help with academic curriculum?
I use sports as an instrument. See, it's something they love. See, if you can find something that somebody loves or children love and let them know that if they don't do a certain thing and accomplish a certain thing and make an effort to do and be something, then you're not going to be able to play.
And this was an issue in the film. There were some students that thought that, or players that thought they weren't going to be able to play anymore because of their academic
and
performance.
They had to miss a game, no doubt, because of, again, and sometimes assistant makes mistakes too, whether it be they didn't handle the business in the classroom, so we have to go on without them. Hopefully it'll work out, but if it doesn't, hey, the show goes on, the game goes on, we must go on.
What are you working on next?
I'm in the process of researching a documentary that deals with the incarceration of young black men and how that has decimated the community. You think about 2.3 million people incarcerated in the United States, which is a quarter of the people incarcerated in the world, and 35% of that is African American. There's something wrong with the criminal justice system.